Welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video.
In this video, I'm going to tell you how to drain down a pressurised heating system. This particular heating system doesn't have a feed and expansion tank in the loft for a ball valve for you to hold up or anything like that. It's completely sealed and airtight. So you have an expansion vessel, cold water fill, and a pressure valve, and a pressure release valve as well. So let's have a look at how you drain one down and fill it up again.
Unfortunately, this means for this particular place, we have to go up into the loft.
So let's have a little look now.
Right, we're up in the loft now. It's very dark. Always watch your footing when you're in a loft. Always make sure you can see the rafters. If you can't, make sure you move any kind of insulation out of the way so you can see. I've managed to locate the pressurisation filling loop, and I'll just show you that now.
Here's the pump. That's the flow from the boiler. This pipe coming down here is the feed pipe. Here is our expansion tank. That'll take any expansion for when the water heats up. So basically it's a rubber diaphragm in there. This side is air and this side here is water. Then we have our pressure gauge, which currently reads about 1 bar, which is about right when it's cold. Heating system should be at about 1.5 bar when it's warm. And there's our first valve from the mains. Mains comes down here and there's our second valve there. So what we do, we turn both of those off. They should be off anyway. And you'll always turn them back off when you finish doing any work on one of these systems, okay? So we turn these two off. The off position always being across the line of the pipe. Remember, when draining any system, to open up any 3-port or 2-port valves. Now we're ready to go downstairs and put our hose on and drain the system down.
Just remember that the components for a pressurised system that I've just shown you can be in other places. For example, if you have a combi boiler or a system boiler, those components will actually be inside the boiler casing itself, or it could be anywhere on the heating system. So have a good look for them, identify them and isolate them before you drain down. A pressurised system doesn't have a feed and expansion tank in the loft, which means it's air sealed. How they are installed in the system is very simple. You have your boiler with its flow to a radiator and it's returned back. You'll have a cold feed coming in to a valve and then a hose that you saw upstairs when I showed you the stuff in the loft. That will go through a manifold that connects to the expansion vessel. Now, the expansion vessel is really important. What it has is a rubber diaphragm inside. On one side of that you have water and on the other side you have air. There's a small Schrader valve or a bite pump valve so that you can pump the airbag up to a certain pressure. Usually you'll pump it up to 1 bar. Also, you have a high pressure relief valve. So if this fails or there's any kind of high pressure in danger, that will dump any pressure out to a safe area outside that's visible so you know there's a problem. This is all connected to the heating system. Now, for safety reasons, there should never be any valves between the heating system or the components of the expansion vessel and the high pressure relief valve. That's very important. Say you put a valve in here and you could shut off this heating system from the high pressure relief valve. What can happen is the boiler could get hot, the system could pressurise, radiators could bulge or joints could break, and you could have floods or people getting burnt, bad things like that happening. When testing the air pressure in the air side of the expansion vessel, only ever do that when the system's drained down and there's no water pressure in there, otherwise you'll get a false reading. There is also at this point here a check valve, otherwise known as a non-return valve, that in a situation where the heating system pressure got above that of the cold water mains coming in, you couldn't push heating system water back into the main supply and eventually a drinking water supply. Now we come downstairs and find the lowest point of the system. Here's our drain off just here on this lowest radiator. Now remember, we've turned the valves off upstairs, so there's no way that water can be introduced into the system. So, pop our hose on here. Sometimes I find it's a good idea to pop a little rag under here. See, this can sometimes leak a little bit. Always remember, run your hose to a nice outside area where people aren't going to get their feet wet. And there we go, you can hear water is now escaping from the system. Open that fully up and then go back upstairs. Now so far, all you've done is turn the water supply off, gone downstairs, put a hose on the drain off and open that up. What will happen is you'll actually pull a vacuum. So you won't see much water actually come out of that drain off until you introduce air to the top of the system. So we come up here, open this air vent up, make sure that these two valves are open. So the thermostatic valve is fully open and the lock shield at the other end is open, and open up the valve. Now you'll hear that allowing air into the system. You should go downstairs and you should be able to find there's water coming out of the end of your hose. Do that to every other radiator upstairs, and after about 10 minutes, wait a little while, do it to all the rads downstairs. If you're working on the radiators just upstairs, then you won't need to drain the ones downstairs, will you? And you can save yourself some time. Once all the water has stopped coming out of the end of your hose and you've vented all the radiators that you want to work on upstairs and downstairs, you can now work on everything. You can now fill the system up again. Now, it's a little bit more complicated, so bear with me. Right, remove your hose and then shut off your drain off. Now we go upstairs and go around all the radiators upstairs and downstairs and shut all their air vents. Once all your air vents are shut and your drain offs are closed, go back to where the pressurisation unit is and the fill loop is and open those valves and start to fill the system. So here we are again. Just switch this valve on here and then switch this one on here. Just open that. Now we are reintroducing water into the system, and you should see this dial start to rise as pressure starts to build. Pressurise it up to about 1.5 bar, then go back downstairs to the radiators and vent them out. As soon as there's no more air coming out and it all stops, go back upstairs and top the system up again. Keep going around doing that until you have water coming out of each radiator and you've turned it off. And then as soon as that's done, go back upstairs, pressurise the system to 1 bar, and you should be done. So to recap, the best tips I have for filling up a pressurised heating system are: never pressurise the system when you're filling it to more than 1 bar, always be with the radiators at the time when you want to let the air out, okay? So in a way, what you do is you pressurise it up to 1 bar, you bleed the rads, when no more air comes out, shut that radiator, go back upstairs, repressurise to 1 bar, open that radiator, okay? Keep doing that until you're pretty much full. Leave the system at 1 bar, and then when it comes and gets hot, when you turn it all on, it should only get up to 1.5 bar. If you need any more help, or if you find this helpful, or you think we've missed something out or anything, contact us through our YouTube page or subscribe, or visit our website at www.plumberparts.co.uk. I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you incredibly soon. Thanks ever so much, guys. Bye.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.